Hi, and welcome to the tutorial for reducing the modeling period on OSeMOSYS. So, I'm going to show you the example on HO8 with 8 time slices. Essentially, when you're building a model, the default setting is to build it to 2070. However, you can build a model to 2050 or whatever year you see fit. This will reduce the modeling period and it will produce the optimal outcome, so the least cost model for up to that period if you have not set any constraints. So to do so, firstly, let's select everything. Then the first thing that we're going to change will be specified annual demand. So we select specified annual demand. When we look at ELC003, and this is how it has been defined, the specified annual demand, it could be the case that you've defined this for industrial electricity, residential electricity, and commercial electricity. You would need to do the following changes on that. And essentially, reducing the modeling period is very simple. What you do is you come to the point where you want to reduce it. So let's say we want our model to run up to 2050. And for the rest of the values, we put 0. So, Control C, Control Shift Right Arrow, Control Shift Right Arrow, Control V. So now what this means is that there is no demand of electricity in the rest of the modeling period. So it's only up to 2050. In this case, the model will only run up to 2050. Having said that, doing just this change does not necessarily mean that the model is going to be modeling for this period. What you would want to do is, when you're building your model, is change as many of the technologies you defined and parameters just up to 2050. So not inputting any data from 2050 onwards. The important ones are the specified annual demand, specified demand profile, and essentially any constraints that you've put on the technology to produce in a certain year. So let's say if before you had put a constraint that there has to be 30% hydropower technology utilized annually and you've defined this up to 2070. What you would need to do is go and remove the data up to 2070 and leave it only up to 2050. And instead of the data that has been put in place, you simply put 0. So for the specified demand profile, 2050 has been defined, so over here I put 0. I control C, control shift right arrow, control V, control C, I go down, control V, control V, control V, control V again until it's all defined to 0. So now the model will calculate only up to 2050. However, if you want to be precise, and this sometimes does happen, that even though you've defined the specified demand profile and the specified annual demand up to 2050, there might be some technologies that will show production in later years. So essentially what you want to do is go through technologies one by one and make sure that they've been defined as such. Whether it's necessary or not, give a try of your model after you've changed specified annual demand and specified demand profile. And if you see that there are some technologies that still produce up to after 2050, when you visualize the results, then change those to 0 as well. So let's say, for example, if I'm going to select, I'm going to unselect everything over here, and I'm going to select power natural gas 001, so natural gas power plant. What I'd want to do is just scroll down over here, and the values that have been put, so let's say the input activity ratio, I'd want to change this to 0 from 2050 onwards. So 2050 onwards, I put this to 0. So in this case, for sure, natural gas power plant cannot work as there's no input activity and the output activity as well. So if I scroll down over here, let's find the output activity ratio, produces LC001. So I go over here. And I change this to 0. So, when defining your model like this, Again, specified annual demand and specified demand profile are the first two important changes that you need to do. The other two important changes that you need to do is going to be the power transmission and power distribution. So this is to ensure that no power is being transmitted at all after the set modeling period and no power is being distributed. So if I go to power dist, for example, okay, the output activity ratio of power dist is ELC003. So I go to 2050, change this to 0, Control C, Control Shift right arrow, Control V, and Control S. Essentially, firstly change the specified annual demand, specified demand profile, run your model, and see if it works. If it only models up to 2050, then everything is fine. If it models for longer than that, so a few technologies model for a bit longer than that, change those technologies and also change power transmission and power distribution. After that, your model should be running up to the period that you want to specify it as. Thank you for watching this video.